Welcome to Desktop Deployment Essentials, our new series to help you prepare for your shift to Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus. In the next few minutes, I'm going to walk you through our third step in our recommended deployment process wheel to prepare you for the delivery of Office and your line of business apps. Now, for those of you starting with Microsoft Office 2010 or a volume activation version of Office 2013 or 2016, don't worry. I'm also going to show you a crash course of what you need to know about click-to-run application packaging for Office and how you can configure your Office apps and get them ready for automated deployment. In step one of our deployment process wheel, I walked you through device and app readiness as the way to inventory your PC hardware and software and prioritize and triage issues by accessing known compatibility information and fixes from Windows and Office. Now, those fixes could be to update, retire, replace, or apply a compatibility fix to ensure that your apps work on Windows 10 and that your add-ins work on Office 365 Pro Plus. Now, one of the biggest decisions you're going to make here is whether to use 32 or 64-bit natively compiled apps, especially when both options exist, such as the case with Office 365 Pro Plus. Now, to take advantage of additional compute and RAM on new devices, it's often worth figuring out any add-in or file-related compatibility challenges to move to 64-bit. If nothing is blocking you from deploying 64-bit Office, it's a good idea to move forward with this option, as it will usually be better and more future-proof choice. So let's talk about where to start. Now, there are many methods and models for installing apps on Windows. So let's look at your options for app delivery, packaging, and distribution of your line of business apps. Now, your LOB apps, you're probably using things like MSI packages or executables to install your apps as part of a deployment task sequence. Tools like System Center Configuration Manager and Intune are optimized to deliver MSI packaged apps, and Windows 10 obviously continues to support those packages. Next, there's Config Manager. If you're using Config Manager now for app delivery, once you've validated your apps on Windows 10, you can either assign them as required apps so that they're automatically installed on all targeted PCs, or you can use Software Center so that users can choose additional apps published by the IT team for their PCs. And of course, if you're using Intune, the company portal serves a similar function across devices. Equally, perhaps one of the most popular app delivery methods is using imaging. Imaging approaches to build and capture can also save time when provisioning new PCs. In this case, applications are either installed by a task sequence or manually, then an image is captured and the required applications are pre-installed. Now remember though, the operating systems as well as the apps inside that image can become stale quickly, especially if images aren't frequently refreshed. Now the cumulative update model for Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus helps with this problem because it contains all the updates between when you sealed that image until when you apply the image. Sometimes that can be several months later. Now this doesn't eliminate all issues associated with staleness completely. This is why we recommend a thin image approach where applications are installed from outside the image at deploy time. Also, Office 365 Pro Plus cannot be pre-activated by the system admin. It's because it's a user-based activation. Now, you can pre-install Office using the Office deployment tool and skip user sign-in. So the user can sign in for the first time Office is launched, then be assigned the activation, and also take advantage of other capabilities that leverage sign-in, like getting to your most recently used files, wherever they are. Now, speaking of Office 365 Pro Plus deployment, you'll need to familiarize yourself with the click-to-run installation approach. Office 365 Pro Plus, in every version of Office in the upcoming 2019 release, uses click-to-run technology versus MSI packaging. It also brings with it a number of advantages like improved installation time, faster and more efficient updating, and cleaner uninstallation. Now, for broad Office 365 rollouts, Configuration Manager Current Branch has native support for the updated Office customization tool, package customization for click-to-run at install time, and native support for software update management post-installation. Microsoft Intune also has native installation configuration support for Office 365 Pro Plus packages. So let's move on to browser-based apps. Beyond your 32 or 64-bit line of business apps, there are a few things to consider in order to make sure that your browser-based applications continue to work as expected. Now, if you have specific websites and apps that you know have compatibility problems with Microsoft Edge, you can use the Enterprise Mode site list so that those websites automatically open using Internet Explorer 11. Now, everything that we've just explored falls into the realm of common approaches currently used to configure, package, and distribute your apps. There are also some new options to consider. First, the Microsoft Store for Business provides a flexible way to discover, acquire, manage, and distribute free and paid apps on Windows 10 devices at scale. As an IT admin, you can manage Microsoft Store apps and private line of business apps all from one inventory, plus assign and reuse licenses as needed. Users can find and install apps that you've approved from the store, and you can publish those along with your own custom apps to your own private store. Store apps can be natively built as UWP apps, or you can use the desktop bridge to repackage your existing apps for the store and add modern experiences for Windows 10. Now, aside from the code that you use to light up Windows 10 experiences, your apps will remain unchanged and they'll just work as is. Next, MSIX is another emerging option for application packaging that uses containerization technology available in Windows and also brings many of the best aspects of Click-to-Run, UWP, and MSI packaging together. As a containerized package, the application will be delivered and dynamically integrated by the operating system. Containerization separates the applications from the operating system, and there are a number of advantages to this, such as clean uninstall and removal of packages. So unlike MSI and EXE-based packages today that leave items on the system, these are much cleaner. You don't need administrative credentials to install or see native Windows integration, so a standard user account will work. So that was an overview of a few core options for app delivery as you prepare for your desktop deployment. Next up, we're going to cover your considerations for migrating user files and settings between Windows environments as you move to the next step in the deployment process wheel. And to learn more about what we covered today, visit our Modern Desktop Deployment Center and keep following our Desktop Deployment Essentials series here on Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching.